Bob Ward wrote a new book called SQL Server Revealed, and he's here to tell us all about it today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have a very special guest, SQL royalty, Bob Ward.
SQL royalty, I don't know. I'm not sure if I heard that one before, but yeah, thanks, Jeroen. Great to be here.
Yeah, so rumor is you wrote another book. I know you had a book on SQL Server on Linux. I read it. I have it. It's signed by you even. Thank you for that.
Yes, you're welcome.
So the rumor is on the street there's another one.
There is another one. Can you believe that? I mean, you'd think after the abuse of writing one, you wouldn't do another one, but
right.
I did. I wrote the first one. It was a hard project. I enjoyed doing it. It was a labor of love. And I got done, and I told my wife and my boys, I'm like, I'm not doing any more of these. They're so hard to do.
Right.
And I don't know. I just got the itch to do another one.
So a couple of years later, you're back at it?
Back to back. I wrote the Linux one, and that came out last year. And almost like a month or two later, I'm starting the next one.
So you said to yourself and to your wife and your family, I'm never going to do
exactly.
this again. And then the next morning you start again.
The next morning I start cranking it out, right? And
okay.
You know, there's this product, you may have heard of it, called SQL Server 2019. Never heard of this, right?
No.
So we had just announced that at Ignite last year. Uh-huh. And that's when the book Linux had come out, was then around that time.
Yeah.
And so I thought to myself, you know, I wonder if I should write a book about 19. It's a lot of work I've been doing over the last year.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the journey. And so the book is called SQL Server 2019 Revealed.
Ooh.
Revealed. That's a kind of, is that a kind of a cool name?
That is a very cool name. And as a matter of fact, I tried searching for it.
Oh, you tried, did you find, you found it.
Is this it?
That is it. Yes.
Cool.
Yes. That is the book. I know. It's kind of a catchy name, I realize.
Yeah.
I think the word revealed just kind of means behind the scenes.
Okay.
Because, Jeroen, one of the things that was fun doing this is I interviewed a lot of people on the engineering team.
Mm-hmm.
This book is really written for the SQL community, but it's powered by the engineering team. So what you have here is a series of chapters that are really stories about functionality in SQL 19 about the engineering team. So, for example, I might have a feature on performance, and I would talk to Pedro Lopes about what the work he did and why did you do it and when did it start.
Okay.
And I like I like history a little bit.
Okay.
So I spent the first chapter talking to Slava Oaks and Travis Wright about how did this all start? Why did y'all start this madness? So there's kind of some fun stories in there as well.
Cool.
It's very conversational. I'm a conversational person,
mm-hmm.
and you'll find that. But it's also got a lot of demos and examples. Almost every chapter has examples on GitHub for you to read, try it out,
So
and
it's
all
a
sorts of things.
Good balance between understanding what's going on, why did we do this, how did we did it.
Correct.
Who did it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Highlighting those people as well. And then learning about
absolutely
how it works and
absolutely.
Doing it yourself.
Absolutely.
So big data clusters?
Yeah.
Did it make it in?
Big data clusters made it in. And I did a really unique approach there. Big data clusters is one of the biggest things we did in 19.
Sure.
But what I chose to do is put that at the end of the book.
Uh-huh.
There's a couple reasons why. One is I'm writing the book during the preview of SQL Server, right?
Okay.
And big data clusters was really a big thing we did during the release. So I wanted to make sure in the book I got almost everything about it that's up to date.
Uh-huh.
So one of the cool things I love about this book is it literally does reflect everything that's in the release of SQL Server 19. Yet I was able to write it during the preview.
Mm-hmm.
The other reason to put big data clusters at the end is that it encompasses what? Containers, Linux, Kubernetes, Polybase. So what I do is in the book, I teach you those concepts in the book. And so then you learn about those basics.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get to big data clusters, you get all that now. So you understand how to put it all together in a solution. So
it's kind of instead of starting with the whole thing in the beginning and then decompose it, you start building it up.
I build it up, right. And kind of end with a bang.
It's kind of like a cliffhanger, maybe.
A little bit of a cliffhanger. Yeah, I think it's a way of looking at it.
To the end of the last
absolutely.
Page. Absolutely. So are there any dirty secrets?
No, there's nothing like that.
But it's revealed, right?
It's revealed. But there are some fun stories of behind the scenes of why we did something.
Okay.
And, always encrypted. Let's pick on that one. It's a security model we have, right, for end-to-end encryption.
Yeah.
Well, I went back to the team and said, where did this start from? As it turns out, it started Microsoft Research. I don't think anybody knows that.
Uh-huh.
And I got a chance to interview the Microsoft researcher.
Cool.
You pick on Polybase. I went back and emailed David DeWitt, one of the original founders of this. I found him at MIT, and I said, why did you do this? So I put that kind of stuff in the book. So I kind of, that's the nuggets that I think people enjoy reading. I did that in Linux, and I did in this book too. So.
Wow. And so this is going to be in time for the holidays, hopefully?
You know, it's in pre-order right now as we speak. And I hope to have this thing out soon, very, very soon, definitely before the holidays.
Okay.
Usually these come form in e-books earlier than the printed versions. Kind of like the Linux book, it's fairly long. I think it's almost like 500 pages.
Yeah.
Which,
you know, the Linux book was pretty...
It was pretty thick.
Yeah.
Now, this book, by the way, Drone, is everything that's new in 19.
Okay.
So, like, you need some fundamental knowledge of SQL,
sure.
I think, to pick it up. But it is end-to-end. It covers everything in the release, from performance to security to availability,
right,
to Linux containers, big data clusters, you name it. I've got it all in there.
And because you mixed it with like stories and
yeah,
background, it doesn't
yeah
feel to me like it's, I mean, I've not read it yet.
Of course, yeah.
But
I can't wait for you to read it though, right?
Okay. Yeah. So it doesn't sound to me like a dry list of features, like, oh, we can do this, we can do this, and this is how you do it, because you have this interaction with the people in the interview style. So really
the other thing I did that was interesting, you might find, is not just listing features. I do it from a challenge solution perspective.
Okay.
Like, mm-hmm, okay, here's your challenge that you have today, and
right,
here's why 19 has things together that give you a solution.
Cool.
Like intelligent performance. You don't want to change your app. You want to get faster. That's a challenge you have. Or I don't want to do a lot of expensive
sure
tuning. How does SQL 19 solve that? And then the cool thing is I'll put in maybe like screenshots of how it looks when you run it,
uh-huh,
or give you an exercise to go do to kind of confirm to put it all together. So
awesome.
Yeah.
So yeah, I cannot wait to get my hands on it.
Well, thank you.
Try
yeah
to,
it was exciting to write. So
yeah, I can see that. So, okay, cool. So everything that you need to know about SQL Server 2019, the way it's built, the why it was built, by
exactly
whom it was built, everything is in this one book called SQL Server 2019 Reveal. Right?
Absolutely, Drone. Yeah, excited to see it come out.
Perfect. So with that, thank you, Bob, for being here.
Thanks for having me.
It's exciting to have you. And thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to the video, comment, and hope to see you next time. Thanks.